Hi, I'm Graham Steele, CEO and founder of Cryptosense, and today I'm going to talk to you about AWS KMS versus Azure Key Vault. So what are these two cryptographic services? So these are the offers that are made by the AWS company, Amazon Web Services, and by Microsoft through their Azure cloud offering to programmers who want to put workloads into these public clouds, but want to keep data protected by cryptography. So in the past, if you were building an application for traditional deployment, so in your own computers, in your own data center, you had essentially two ways of using cryptography or encryption to protect that data. So if your data wasn't so sensitive, you could do that encryption in software, use a software library and record the keys, say, into a database or protect them with a password on the disk or whatever it was. And if you had really sensitive data, then probably you would make use of some cryptographic hardware. So something like an HSM, a hardware security module. So a separate computer you would connect to the computer, your server, where your data was being processed, that would hold the keys and carry out the cryptography. So the cloud service operators wanted to offer the same kind of security as an HSM, so to protect your cryptographic keys away from your application. So if the application is compromised, perhaps you don't lose those keys, but they didn't want to use a traditional HSM architecture where everybody gets their own box, because that's not going to scale to a cloud kind of world. So both Amazon and Microsoft came up with a similar kind of design for a sort of hybrid between a traditional HSM and doing software cryptography. And these are these KMS key management system or key broker services. So in both of these, in Microsoft's Azure product and in AWS KMS, you have the principle of a master key. So these master keys are protected by the key management service, and they never leave the key management service. They're never exposed outside in the clear. We have a whole video about how that's done. Then the interesting thing is that they have a very different way of managing those master keys and giving you access to them to do some data protection, some cryptography, some signature, whatever it is you need to do. The big difference is that in AWS KMS, these master keys are symmetric keys. So they're 256-bit AES keys. So they're symmetric keys. That means that I encrypt and decrypt with exactly the same key. So once that key is secret inside the AWS KMS, I'm never going to see that. I'm never going to be able to do my own decryption or encryption, because if it did, it means I could get hold of the key. So everything is going to take place inside the AWS KMS server. In Microsoft Azure, the master keys are asymmetric key pairs. So they're a pair of a public key and a private key. The private key is used to do the decryption or the signature, and the public key is used to do the encryption or verification of signatures. And that public key really is public. I can leave that around. I can put it on my own servers. I can put it in the clear around the place, because having knowledge of the public key doesn't give any help to anybody who's trying to do decryption. So anybody can encrypt data with a public key, but only the private key, which is stored inside the Azure Key Vault, can actually do the decryption. So this actually makes a difference how you get hold of a key to do your encryption and decryption with, because the way that these systems work is the master keys only do a very small amount of encryption and decryption. The idea of them is that they are a high level in the hierarchy, and they're going to encrypt and decrypt a data key, so a small key that you're going to keep, and that data key you're going to use in your software, on your application, to do the encryption and decryption of big piles of data that you need to put in the database or store in blobs or whatever it is you want to do. But because the asymmetric and symmetric difference is there, the way you get hold of these keys is quite different. So in AWS, the typical way that you go through the SDK to encrypt a blob of data is that you ask the AWS KMS to generate you a fresh data key. The AWS KMS will encrypt that fresh data key with the master key that is protected inside the KMS, and it will send you both the clear version and the encrypted version. It'll send these over TLS, of course. It won't send them in the clear, but it'll protect them just with a layer of network cryptography. And then on your server, on your application, you can store the encrypted version for later when you need to do decryption, and you can take the clear version and encrypt a bunch of data with it. So you're taking advantage of the AWS KMS to do the key generation for you, which can be good because you can use their compliance docs and so on to show that that's going to work well. But you haven't actually got control of that. That isn't you generating that key, and you have to rely on a call to the KMS to get that done. In the Microsoft Azure version, well, there's no point asking the Azure Key Vault to generate you the key, because you've got the public key to do the encryption of your data key yourself. So typically you generate your own data key, encrypt your data with it, and then you encrypt your data key with the public key that corresponds to the private master key that's being stored by Azure Key Vault. And then you've got all that done, and Azure Key Vault doesn't even know that this has happened, that you've encrypted some more data. It's only going to find out about that when you send it over for decryption. So the pattern of who has responsibility for the generation of the keys and who knows that they've been stored and the way that the keys are flowing between the KMS and the client is actually quite different in these two paradigms. And you want to study those carefully to make sure that they meet your requirements for the way that you want to deploy your application and the way that you're going to get it audited and certified and so on. So I should say that you can do asymmetric cryptography with AWS, particularly you can do signature and verification, but that's not the primary way that they manage keys. Primarily it's through symmetric key. At the moment, you can't do symmetric key crypto with Azure Key Vault, although you can store individual secrets there. And you can, if you want, in AWS, generate your own data keys, just again, that doesn't fit with the pattern of the way that their SDKs are generally set up, so you have to be careful about working that out for yourself. There's a lot of little details in there that can make the difference between you passing your compliance and getting the security requirements that you really need. So if you want to find out more about these services, we have a great in-depth comparison on an article on the Cryptosense website. You can even get hold of a white paper that really goes into detail about how all these things work. And I'm very happy to look at any questions you might have about these right here in the comments below. After that, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to make sure you find out about new videos about modern cryptography, and hope to see you here again soon.